So now we have an understanding of the main muscles of the face as well as the neck and the back. So let's move anteriorly and discuss the muscles of the thorax. So let's remember what we're talking about in terms of area. So let's talk about the thoracic cage or review it really quickly. So remember we have these ribs. How many ribs do we have? We have 12, right? 12 on each side, and each of these ribs either have their own costal cartilage, which is indicated here in this kind of tan right here, or they have a shared costal cartilage. So you're going to have muscles that are going to be in between in these intercostal spaces right here, as well as muscles superficial to that that are going to play more of a role in terms of the shoulder joint. So these axio-appendicular muscles, they're going to extend from that thoracic cage all the way to the humerus. So anytime that you cross over the shoulder joint, that means that it can have some type of role in the movement of the shoulder joint. So that's what these muscles are doing here. So you can see one of the main ones right here, we refer to this as your pec or your pectoralis major. This is going to have most of its belly right here in terms of the thorax, but it's actually going to attach over here in terms of the humerus. So it's not going to play a big role in terms of movement of the ribs. It's going to play a role in terms of movement of the shoulder joint. But I wanted to make sure that we understand that there are these superficial muscles here. Your serratus anterior is another example of that. So we'll talk more about these muscles when we talk about the upper limb a little bit later. But the main muscles of the thorax are these intercostal muscles. So let's get an understanding of where we're at. So here are ribs. Excuse me. Here are ribs right here. And I told you that we're going to fill in those intercostal spaces with muscle. And you're going to have three main types of muscles: external, internal, and innermost, and they make sense. The external is going to be the most superficial, internal is right underneath, and then innermost, very closely associated with the internal intercostal muscles. Let's talk about fiber. So what we're seeing mostly right here are your external intercostal muscles, and you can see them, the direction of their fibers. All right. Think about putting your hands in your pocket. That's the direction that these fibers are going. Whereas the internal intercostals, you can see, are going perpendicular. Kind of think about getting the hair out of your face. That's the direction of your internal intercostal muscles. So it's important that these muscle fibers are perpendicular to one another to really provide extra stability in this region. Because if you think about what's right underneath or deep to your thorax, you have those lungs right there. So you need that additional protection of those very important organs. Now, these muscles, while they are while they play a big role in terms of increasing just the stability or the tone of this region, they don't play a big role in terms of active movement, okay? So they're not playing the big role in terms of flexion, extension, because they're not attached to the spinal column. Now, in cases where you have forced inspiration, so take a really deep breath, those external intercostals are gonna play a role. Whereas if you really kind of blow the air out, like you're mad or something like that, that's forced expiration, and your internal intercostals are going to play a role there. Typically, the main thing that's causing expiration, that's a passive movement, so gravity is really allowing that. And really, in terms of inspiration, that's going to be the diaphragm muscle, which we'll talk about in another section. That's going to be the main muscle there. So these are really in cases where you're having, you're really thinking about, you know, breathing in and breathing out, those particular muscles will play a role. So these are really the only muscles that we're going to talk about in terms of the thorax. These are the main ones. We'll move into some of the deeper muscles or the cardiac muscles when you get into the cardiorespiratory sequence.